The way the human body works is both highly intricate and incredibly well coordinated, and one of those precise mechanisms we're going to talk about today is truly mind-blowing. But if we're not eating enough of two particular foods, we may be unknowingly disrupting this specific and critically important process. I recently heard Dr. Michael Greger talk about this phenomenon in the body that is so pertinent right now, and you'll discover why later in the video. The power of plant-based foods, and in particular two types of plant foods, never ceases to amaze me. And as I said earlier, this is also an important reminder that if we're not prioritizing these two foods in our diet, we will be missing out on an all-important feedback mechanism. So let's hear now from Dr. Michael Greger of nutritionfacts.org.
There's also something called an ileal break phenomenon. Yes. When calories reach our ileum, which is the last part of the small intestine, there are these L cells that are activated, and GLP-1 is produced and puts the brakes on eating more. So we have this natural GLP-1 satiety mechanism, which fails because most of the components of food we eat these days are quickly digested, absorbed at the beginning of our small intestine. We're eating refined grains and sugar and oils, etc. So these calories never make it down to the end of the small intestine where GLP-1 secreting cells are concentrated. And you say, wait a second, why would our body develop an appetite regulation system based on calories ending up in our colon when most of the calories get absorbed further on up in the digestive tract, no matter how much we eat? That's because when we were evolving, there was no such thing as table sugar, no such thing as Wonder Bread, no such thing as vegetable oil. For millions of years before we started sharpening spears and milling grains and boiling sugar cane, our entire physiology is presumed to evolve in the context of eating what the rest of our great ape cousins eat, and that's a diet centered around whole plant foods, the only concentrated source of fiber, which then traps calories, takes it down to the end of the small intestine to activate the ileal break. Legumes and whole grains are the most concentrated sources of fiber. 97% of Americans don't even reach the recommended minimum daily intake of fiber, and so it is our greatest nutrient deficit out of the 50 things that are attracting the American diet.
So many people will say, but I eat tons of fruits and veggies, so surely this will stimulate that ileal break. But in fact, vegetables are 80% water and fruits around 90%, so don't contain as much fiber as, say, black beans and oat groats. But now let's hear more about this phenomenal mechanism.
The GI tract is actually the largest hormone-secreting gland in the body. There are about 20 peptide hormones. About one in every 100 cells lining our digestive tract acts as a nutrient sensor and secretes these hormones accordingly, one of which is this glucagon-like peptide 1, GLP-1. Its primary action is to signal satiety to the brain, but critically important is these nutrient-sensing cells that release GLP-1 are located at the end of our digestive tract, at the last part of the small intestine, and throughout the colon. Now, this makes sense, right? If they're way high up, right, then we eat something and we get satiated too early, right? Be like, oh, I'm already full. The big problem throughout most of our evolutionary history was scarcity, right? We want to eat a lot of food when it's available. But, oh my God, if food is getting all the way down to the terminal ileum, oh, okay. At that point, the body's like, all right, we're going to put some cells in there. You know, once the food makes it all the way down that far, we have to tell the brain, okay, let's shut it down because you're obese and you're not going to, you know, run from the saber-toothed tiger as well. Normal natural foods that contain fiber, it'll form this fibrous mass that pulls calories down the digestive tract. You know, they do these studies with oil. If you literally drink liquid oil on a high-fiber diet, there's more fat excretion in the feces because you think, well, all oil calories would be instantly absorbed. You know, they're acellular in the high up in the small intestine, but on a high fiber diet, you're only going to absorb calories through the intestinal lining. And it's not even going to reach the intestinal lining, but it's trapped in this fibrous mass as it should be, as is natural. And so whole natural plant foods pull calories down to the end of the small intestine, to the colon, to signal natural satiety mechanisms. However, these fiber-free foods, these ultra-processed foods, that are not protectively wrapped in this indigestible fibrous cell walls gets absorbed way high. Eat a donut, everything gets absorbed way high in the small intestine, and there's just no residue. There's nothing left to make it down to where these GLP-1 signaling cells are. So we are undermining, we are subverting our natural satiety mechanisms when we eat this ultra-processed junk. So our body is getting this It's like we're starving all the time. Like no food is making it down to the end of the small intestine.
Next, we'll discover the grain that is said to be the grain that contains the most antioxidants. To view that video, you can click the middle of the screen now or head to the pinned comment at the top of the comments below.